My name is Amar, and I lead Project Fiddle here at Microsoft Research. My colleagues and I are working on speeding up distributed machine learning jobs. Our emphasis has been on distributed deep learning. DNN models are expensive to train, not just in the amount of resources they consume, but also in the amount of time they take to train these DNN models. And so the motivation for these systems, you know, we have this new generation of big data systems in this generation of AI. We have applications such as, we have tasks such as image recognition, classification, translation, and speech to text and text to speech conversion. And there have been various solutions that have been proposed over the years. So I think the first generation of solutions like Disbelief and Project Adam looked at using commodity computers to solve some of these problems using DNNs. And the next generation of systems like TensorFlow and Microsoft CNTK were generalizations that, you know, let the programmers specify how to code up these DNNs and solve many of these tasks, as opposed to, you know, point solutions for specific tasks. But the key factor that still remains is DNN training is extremely time and resource consuming. And so jobs, training jobs last days to multiple weeks at times. And there's this constant cycle of train, validate, repeat, which, you know, blows up the training time effectively. One of the most important things in this work is naively parallelizing this work can actually be detrimental, because what really matters at the end of the day is the quality of work or time to reach a certain accuracy. And so the problem that we're trying to solve here is we've set an ambitious goal for ourselves. We'd like to perform 100x more efficient training. Intuitively, what this means is if you have a model that takes an entire day to train, we'd like to train this model in 15 minutes over your coffee break. And the approach we take in Project Fiddle is to cut across the system stack. So, you know, we look at training, the bigger picture of training, from a single GPU all the way up to multi-GPU, multi-machine clusters across the system stack. So we look at the memory subsystem. We look at how to structure computation across these different computational units. We look at the communication infrastructure. So, you know, it's speeding up communication, which is inherent in this workload. And then finally, all the way up the stack, you know, I've been talking about these innovations that help a single job, but we look at sort of multiple jobs all using the same cluster running in this multi-tenant clustered environment. And we're looking at techniques to make fault-tolerant, elastic training work on these clusters. Let me take a very specific example, you know, to keep you grounded in example. So one of the projects, GIST, looks at how much more can we do on a single GPU. So, you know, before you ask for your second GPU, we'd like to make sure that you're maxing out the capabilities of a single GPU. So let's move here where I explain GIST. The first thing to note here is what I'm showing you here is memory is a bottleneck for even single GPU training. So sorted on this x-axis, we've sorted different DNNs for image classification, effectively sorted them over time. And you'll note that the memory consumed by these different DNNs over time increases. We further dug deeper and, you know, we wanted to find out what in there is consuming memory. And the stuff that's marked in red, that's highlighted in red, are the heavy hitters. And those are the feature maps that are stored and needed for backward computation during DNN training. So to explain this in sort of an abstract way, here's the representation of a DNN layer. You can think of any layer taking as input X, outputting some feature map Y, and then in its backward pass, it's going to take some output gradient dy and output sort of this gradient dx. And dx is a function of x, y, and dy. It could be a function of x, y, and dy. And so to compute dx now, we need to actually store x and y. So this is sort of the abstract view of what a layer does. If we unroll this over time, this is the same representation of that. We've unrolled it over time. Li here takes as input x and outputs y, and much later in its backward pass, takes as input dy and outputs dx. And so, you know, if you just looked at the lifetime of this data structure x, it's first generated here, and then, you know, used here and discarded here. But we know better. X is actually just used in this time slot, not used, you know, in this long gap, and then used again here during the backward pass of Li. And so now we have an opportunity here to take this data structure, encode it, and hopefully have a succinct representation of X in this long time gap, relinquish all the memory that X was consuming, and then decode that encoded representation into a full-fledged representation again when we need to do backward computation. So just takes in the original computation graph for a particular task, and statically, for every data structure, augments this computational graph to have these encode-decode edges, and our memory manager effectively manages all these memory regions. I was hand-waving here when I talked about encode and decode functions, but specifically, we have a bunch of techniques, both lossless and lossy techniques, that are used for these encode and decode functions. And the higher order bit here is using these, using GIST for these networks, we can get up to a 2x compression ratio. Encode decode, of course, is not free. For these different networks, there's a minimal overhead of 1% to 7% that we pay for the same mini batch size. But the beauty of GIST is we can enable larger mini batch sizes to be loaded. And so, with larger mini batch sizes, we'll have faster training. So this was GIST, which is one extreme of the spectrum, making a single GPU do more effectively. Let me take you to this other extreme, which is multi-machine training. So parallel programming is hard in general. And I want to showcase why it's harder parallelizing DNN training. So for that, let's move on to this particular terminal. And I'm going to skip ahead a couple of slides to get to a slide where I talk about parallel training. So let me talk about Pipe Dream, which is a new way to parallelize DNN computation. So the most important thing to note here is naive parallelization can hurt DNN training. Because if you naively parallelize something, you might actually be increasing the total time for training. Because total time of training depends on two things, time per epoch and the number of epochs for a given accuracy. And while you might decrease the time per epoch, you might be increasing the number of epochs effectively. One of the predominant ways of parallelizing DNNs is this thing called data parallel training, where you run multiple replicas, and these replicas communicate with each other every so often. And if you aggregated all the times for compute and communication stalls, you notice this pattern where there is a bunch of time you're spending just communicating. The problem there, of course, is that of hardware efficiency. You're waiting for communication to occur, and you're not doing any compute. This is including optimizations like weight-free backpropagation that try to sort of pipeline communication and computation. So this was a fake graph. Let me show you a real graph. Here's different networks, image classification, RNNs that we tried out. And one thing that you'll notice is as you increase the number of workers, so let's just consider one of those DNNs. As you increase the number of workers for a given GPU setting, let's take K80s for example, you'll notice that the amount of time that's taken in communication of, to communicate these parameters for parameter exchange is going up. So we're plotting communication overhead as a percentage of total time. But what's worse is as you start using faster compute, so if you go from K80s to V100s, your compute is going much faster, but the amount you're communicating is still the same. And so the communication overhead shoots up dramatically. The other approach that's used for parallel training is this thing called model parallelism, where you take a model and split it up across sort of different GPUs. And so this is most commonly used to work around memory limitations, if you can't load an entire model onto one GPU. So this is great and enables you to at least train this model. But there are two sort of major challenges. One, it's extremely hard for the programmer to figure out where to split this model. These splits will vary not just based on the DNN that's being trained, but also will vary based on the deployment in question. And the second is that of low hardware efficiency. So you'll notice in this figure that only one GPU effectively is active at any given point in time, and all the other GPUs are sitting idle because of the nature of this computation. To do backward work at machine one for mini batch one, it has to wait for the work to go through all the other machines and come back to it. So the idea we have in Pipe Dream is to, we're sort of going to take a relook at model parallelism, but not for memory limitations, but instead for throughput. And we're going to use this idea of pipelining. So we're going to admit more number of jobs into the pipeline. And at the same time, we'd like to have the programmer not have to specify how to parallelize this workload. And so we have a tool that automatically figures out what the right parallelization scheme is, and then a runtime that executes this, and the programmer is not involved in this process at all. And so the way this is done is, I'm just going to skip to the slide that talks about this. We take a DNN run it through our profiler, and this run is just on one of the GPUs. It doesn't have to run on all the GPUs that you're going to run this on. And it spits out a profile of per layer times, as well as how much data is communicated between layers. And based on this information, and given the number of machines that you want to run this on, our optimizer can spit out a configuration for parallelization. And so, Pipe Dream combines model parallelism, data parallelism, and pipelining, and the speedups that we observe because of this combined pipelining is significant. We get up to 5x speed up for various tasks that we've tried this out for, be it image classification or RNNs, for example, sequence-to-sequence models that do video-to-text transcription. So to wrap things up, so in Project Fiddle, we are building we're doing systems research to speed up DNN training, and we take a broader view of training from single GPUs to multiple GPU, multiple machine setup, and we cut across the system stack from the memory subsystem to how to structure computation automatically to communication that's inherent in this training paradigm, all the way up to fault-tolerant, elastic training on shared multi-tenant clusters. Thanks.